Hi, I'm Adam, and I'm from the Sakari team. In this video, I'm going to walk through how to set up the Sakari HubSpot text messaging integration. With this integration, you can send and receive SMS messages directly from your HubSpot account. You can have two-way conversations directly on a HubSpot contact record, and you can create automation by adding HubSpot text messaging to deal-based and contact-based workflows. In this video, I'll walk through how to set up the HubSpot SMS integration. We'll review some account level customization options. We'll walk through a few tips and tricks to getting started, and I'll look at some basic messaging in HubSpot. We are currently logged into the Sakari Hub. This is the main interface to be able to manage your Sakari account, your Sakari users, and your billing. To set up the HubSpot integration, I'll select Integrations in the left navigation, and then click on HubSpot. Now I'll click the red Connect button. This will redirect me to a HubSpot page where I can select the account that I want to connect. I'll then approve the connection by clicking Grant Access, and I'll be redirected back to Sakari. The integration between HubSpot and Sakari has now been set up, but prior to sending any text messages, we need to first synchronize Sakari with your existing HubSpot users. To do that, we'll click the blue Synchronize button in the top left. We'll confirm that we want to sync the data, and the data will begin processing. Depending on the number of contacts that you have, this may take a couple of minutes, but you'll receive an email when it's been completed. Out of the box, we've set up our HubSpot SMS integration with a number of account level customizations. I'll walk through these now. The first are real-time syncs, updates, and deletes. Anytime you add, change, or delete a contact in HubSpot, the contact will automatically be updated in real time. We recommend keeping these all on. The next are timeline events. When turned on, anytime a text message is sent or received against a contact, it is recorded on the contact's timeline. The next are user permissions. When turned on, HubSpot will use a dedicated phone number that's mapped to each user. This feature requires additional setup by the Sakari team, so please contact us if this is something that you're interested in. The next are user notifications. When combined with user permissions, this will send an email notification to the user of a dedicated phone number when an inbound text message is received. The next is the mapped mobile property. This will define what field in HubSpot is recognized as the mobile phone number field. By default, there are two phone number fields in HubSpot. They are phone number and mobile phone number. You can select either field or use a cascade. As an example, if I were to select mobile phone number, phone number, we will attempt to use the mobile phone number first for a contact, but if that's blank, we'll use the phone number field. The next is contact owner consent. This will only allow the mapped contact owner to send text messages to that contact. And then the final option is the creation of a contact in HubSpot when none exists. When enabled, if an inbound text message is received from a phone number that is not recognized, a contact is automatically created in HubSpot. After making any changes to your account settings, be sure to click the blue Save button to save your settings, and then the Synchronize button in the top left to resync your contacts. We've now completed the integration between HubSpot and Sakari, so we'll now move into HubSpot and take a look at a couple of the tips and tricks to getting started. We're now in HubSpot. After you set up the integration, there are two places that you can send text messages in HubSpot. The first is on the contact record, and the second is in workflows. I'll walk through each briefly in this video. For more in-depth tutorials on HubSpot text messaging, please see our blog posts and other videos. We'll first go to the contact record, and since we've just set up the HubSpot texting integration, there are two items that we want to set up for the first time. The first is to ensure that the Sakari integration is being included in the timeline events. To check that, we'll click on the Filter Activity button and ensure that the Sakari integration has been turned on. The second is to move our SMS module up. Now that we've set up the SMS integration, a new Send SMS button has been added to the right sidebar in the contact record. By default, this will often be buried all the way down to the right. I'll scroll down, we can see it reflected here, and I can drag it up by putting my cursor over these dots and then pulling it up. I'll drag it to the top and expand it, and we'll see that there's a new Send SMS button that's been added to the contact record. Now that we've set up the SMS integration, we're ready to send our first text message. To do that, I'll open my contact record and click the Send SMS button. This will open a new pop-up window where I can type my message and click the Send button. When my contact responds, I'll be able to review the response here as well as on the timeline. I've received a response, and I can view that by clicking the Send SMS button, see what the contact has come back with, and type my response. We'll now look at the second way to be able to send text messages in HubSpot, and that's using workflows. I'll select Automation and then Workflows. Sakari supports both contact-based as well as deal-based workflow messaging. And we'll walk through a couple of basics here. We have more in-depth tutorials on our blog as well as our YouTube channel. I'll select Create Workflow with a contact-based workflow from scratch. Now we're in the contact-based workflow creation. Sakari and HubSpot can be used both as an enrollment trigger as well as an action, and we'll take a look at both. First, looking at triggers, by selecting Set Enrollment Triggers and scrolling down, you'll see that there are two new SMS triggers available to you. These can be used as a trigger in any contact-based workflow. Common applications of these triggers would be to automatically create a task when a text message response is received, or to enroll a contact in a list based upon a sent keyword. Sakari can also be used as an action. I'll click the orange plus sign to add an action, and you'll see that there's a new Send SMS integration available to you. By clicking on this, we can add text messaging to any contact-based workflow. To set up the Send SMS action, we need to populate at a minimum the phone number, the message, and the messaging type. To populate the phone number, I recommend using tokens. To add a token, I'll click the Contact Token button, type phone number, and select the phone number field. I also have the option of having a fallback option as well. In this case, I'd like to use the phone number first, but if that's not populated, use the mobile phone number. To do that, I'll add a comma immediately after phone number and add the secondary token of mobile phone number. I'll now define my message, and I have a choice of either using entirely static text or static text in combination with contact tokens. I'll type my message, I'll add a token of the first name, and then add additional text after that. I'll now select a messaging type of either transactional or marketing. If I select marketing, the legally required opt-out text will be added as a suffix to my message. If I select transactional, no additional text will be added. I'll select transactional and click Save. I've now set up Sakari as an action in my workflow. So that's it. We've covered the basics of getting started with HubSpot text messaging from Sakari. We're here to help if you need additional resources to get started. I recommend checking out our footer of our website. There you'll find links to our support articles, our blogs, our YouTube channel, as well as a link to our website chat. Feel free to reach out. Have a great day. Thanks.